Hi, this is Jorge Valle, and I'm gonna show you all the new features of Atlux 2. I have been working on this update for about 10-11 months, and I'm incredibly excited to finally share it with you. So I hope you enjoy everything that the new version brings, including a new UI, more light assets, backdrops, 3D models, post-process materials, LUTs, and even a scan preset to transform your Unreal Engine scenes into Gaussian splats. So I'm gonna show you here this video. I've pre-recorded it. I'm gonna voice it over, showing you all the new features and everything that was already there, but that has been improved. So as you can see, there are new studio presets with Gobos, with a garage preset, some of the classic ones. This one also brings some post-process materials on top. There are also the new studio generator. This used to be the AI randomizer. Now it has been improved into a full-on studio generation so that you can have some inspiration for different lighting and so on. It also has the option to generate only lights, so you can set the studio around and then generate random lights with a bit of a curated feeling. And you can also randomize the light colors, so you can have a play and get some inspiration to see what works best with your models. And it also has custom or random materials. So it randomizes all the materials in the scene, in this case the backdrop, but it would also work with props and so on. In the light tab, we have a few new light presets as well, and on top of new light assets. So here we're gonna see a few of the LED panel. So this is the underwater with light function, the LED panel, the gobo, and yeah, a few more gobos here. So I'll show you that in a bit below. When applying a light, so either with a softbox or a spotlight, we have these procedural gobos here. So you can apply them straight from the UI and then tweak the parameters from the same UI. And I've crafted all of it from scratch. It was great fun making all these gobos, so I hope you enjoyed them as well. It even has a Sauron or Midon preset that it was quite fun to develop. And these light functions work pretty much the same as the gobos, but they are world space aware. So instead of being a 2D texture, they are 3D textures. On top of that, we have the new prop tab with VFX references, so color checkers, classic VFX spheres to check the lighting and the reflections, things like magic, so particles, gold rays, also many props. You see here some podiums, some backdrops, some placeholder items, and you can see here a bit of the placement mode as well, that has been improved. Things with clothing as well, like backdrops with clothes and podiums and so on. So this gives a whole new set of possibilities with the plugin. These are the backdrops. In the details panel, you can check all the possibilities, all the different models for it. You can apply materials straight from it and change the color from the color palette that I will explain in a bit as well. So yeah, it has that curated color palette that I'll show you in a bit. Also, there are podiums, so they are great for product visualization. Things like putting your product on top of the podium and getting a nice visual of it, or even as a side prop on the scene. We have the color checkers as well, so calibrated color checkers in different versions. We have the classic one with the frame, but also spheres and gradients. There are new materials as well, so you can drag and drop them straight from the UI and apply them into the props or into any mesh that you have in the scene, including some experimental materials that you can see here, like the clay or the Voronoi aspect or the UV checker. The curated color palette is a palette of colors that I've selected that I feel they are very pleasing for visualization. So instead of having to go through the color picker and kind of like tweak the color every time, you can start with a pretty well-defined color from the start. There are also decals, so things like footprints, fingerprints, hands, lips, and it's all easy to drag and drop from the UI, and the details panel have been tweaked so that you can just edit the color, edit the opacity, and so on. And this is the keys decal, so you can add a keys to any model in your scene. There are also particle effects, so things like fairy lights, in this case it's like a fairy light volume. There is also a fairy light curtain. We can see it here. Yep. And these also work with path tracer, and it affects the global illumination. This is the dust particle effect. Really cool to see like an old vintage scene. And the hyperspeed effect. This was mainly for fun, just to develop. I've also developed a whole new set of light trails. They are based in splines, so they are fully parametrical. You can edit in the details panel things like the intensity, the taper, the turbulence, the fall off. They are fully parametrical from scratch. And the spline itself can be edited. I'll show you here in a bit. With this, you can create things like light trails as if it was a light painting with like a long exposure setting in the real life, or like a car light trail, for example, that I was showcasing there. And this one, I believe I will show in a bit. Yes, yeah. The editing of the spline. So I have some presets for the light trails, but you can create your own and you can edit them just by tweaking the spline. Wherever you want. So a massive amount of possibilities with this. We also have the new fog volumes, so including things like smoke, a cloud, some like god rays that I showed earlier. It also has an aurora borealis. It's more for an open world visualization, maybe more than a studio, but it was quite cool to develop. They don't work with path tracer at the moment. They work with Lumen, but there is a version for path tracing that includes the classic fog without the effects. So that's the whole new prop tab. Then we also have the action tab, where we have the platforms, so presets like turntables that you can just select your model and apply straight to it. The floating action platform that gives a floating impression. The handheld, this works really well with cameras, for example, where you have like a handheld animation, and also the breathe animation. I use this one for meditation, for example. You enable it and you breathe with the animation, and it's quite soothing. On top of this, we have the classic, the rig rail presets. So this was already in the previous version, hasn't been touched much in this one, but they are still useful for camera animation, for example, or light animations. So you can select the camera, apply the rail, and it just adds that rail surrounding the target that you can animate later in the sequencer, but it also animates by default with the shoot button when rendering. We also have this new post-process tab, including procedural post-process volumes, post-process materials, things like sketching, like pencil drawing, and all of them can be tweaked with all the parameters, so you can customize them to your liking. Each preset or each post-process material has some variation presets as well, so I've set a bunch of different options for each one. Things like, yeah, this blueprint option, the painterly one was great fun to develop. It took me a while to get there, but I love the result. And yeah, as you can see, it has also quite a few different variations. Toon shader, so classic comic style with like a halftone parameter, a cell shading that you can tweak. Everything is parametrical. And you can save your own material instances as well. You don't need to edit, use the materials from the Atlux UI. You can create your own material instance of them and then tweak them later. Things like pixelated with a few variations that give a bit of fun. Things like the push pin or this Lego that we are gonna see now, I believe. Yes, yeah, this one, like a Lego mosaic. I'm a big fan of Lego, so this was great fun also to create. And then use a few more glasses, Polaroid filter, like a Polaroid photo out of the viewport, and many more that you can see there. On top of the post-process materials, we also have LUTs straight from the UI. So with one click, they get applied into the scene already, and you can tweak the intensity or even add your own LUT. I've also developed an importer for LUTs, so cube files can be imported. This is the override materials, so you can create now like a clay render or a UV checker for the whole scene, or like a reflective material for the whole scene just to check lighting, check shapes, and so on. So it's an override material for rendering. Then we have the capture tab, which is the new tab that enclosures the cameras, but also the new assets of the camera volume and the point cloud. So here we have just the camera presets. They are different camera positions that you can select, pretty standard. But then we have the Gaussian splatting and photogrammetry scans. This is a full new asset that I've developed. It's a camera volume, so the volume itself creates all the cameras inside based on different distributions that you can tweak in the details panel. So you can adjust the camera count easily. You can change the distribution for different examples, like the latitude or the Fibonacci distribution. This is great for training like synthetic data with Gaussian splattings to see what works best. And the camera, so all the cameras adapt to the target, they both in rotation and location, so they get the best scan possible based on where the target is. excuse me for that. And yeah, you can add one as well in the back to get more of a bigger view of the scene, and I'll show you later how this looks like in Gaussian splatting. On top of the 3D scan preset, I've also created this point cloud asset. So it scans the scene, it has a volume in it that you can adapt, and everything inside gets passed into a point cloud that you can export either in PLY or Colmap data, and it also exports itself with the Gaussian splat preset. So here's the Gaussian splat export. So all the cameras that I showed earlier, they get one render each, and they get imported into this is PostShot in particular, but any Gaussian splatting rendering software. And I've automated the process, so all the call map data of the cameras and the point cloud and so on is exported automatically just when hitting shoot. So this gives you the opportunity to transform your Unreal Engine scenes into Gaussian splats, which is a technology that I'm really passionate about and that I love exploring. And I really want to see more of it. So this gives you the opportunity to train a bit, test it out. And as you can see, this is the fully generated. This has been sped up quite a lot, obviously. It takes about maybe 3 hours to get to this clean state of Gaussian splat. But this is already a working Gaussian splat from an Unreal Engine scene. And I'll show you, this is still from PostShot, but you can export it as a PLY and import it into a web browser, a web-based Gaussian splatting viewer, as I will show in a bit, which allows you to share Unreal Engine scenes. Yeah, this one is the Super Splat viewer. It's a free viewer online. So you can import your Gaussian splats and you can share it with someone or use, have a visualizer of splats in the web. So amazing technology. I'm really excited about this option. On top of that, we have the sequence and the render tabs. They have been improved and optimized quite a lot. There is the custom sequence that hasn't changed much, but there are also a new render queue, new batch options for batch rendering, and the render settings tab has been improved a lot. So the render presets are really, really quick, really easy to access. And on top of that, there is a OCIO configuration tab. And the Lumen and path tracing switch has been just added to the top, to the bottom of the UI, so it's easier to switch. And on top of that, when hitting render, so shoot button is a one-click render, no need to create sequences or anything. And then there is this new updated render window that shows the progress, shows a bit of information, and it has a nicer UI, closer to the rest of the plugin than it had before. So yeah, this is pretty much it. Use the making visualization easier in Unreal Engine. That's my goal with Atlux, and it's been a journey of 10-11 months that I've thoroughly enjoyed. So thanks so much for watching and for choosing Atlux, and I hope you like it as well. And I look forward to seeing your results. Thanks so much. Reach out if you need anything.